This Shotcut square video tutorial shows you how to make square videos by cropping or resizing the original footage to fit a square viewport. Let's get straight into it.
The very first thing we want to do when we are using Shotcut to create a square video is set the video mode correctly. So on a brand new project, you would select your folder, type in the name of your project, and then click into video mode. As you can see, there are lots of predefined options for you, but none of these, as far as I'm aware, are square. So what we need to do is come down to custom, add, and then type in the name for what you want this custom video mode to be. I'm going to call mine square video. The resolution needs to be the same on the vertical and horizontal axis, so you've got the same amount of pixels going vertical and horizontal. I would recommend a minimum of 720 by 720. If you've got a low-end camera, then it's likely that you will record in 720p. If that's the case, then 720 is the number of pixels that you have on your vertical axis when you're recording in portrait mode. So if you set both of these axes to 720, you know that one of them is going to be correct, and you only need to edit the sides of your video if you're recording in portrait mode. Effectively, what you want to do is work out the lowest number of pixels on either your horizontal or vertical axis, and then copy that lowest number into both of these boxes. For me, I usually record in 1080p, so mine would be 1080 by 1080, because the other axis is 1920, so that's a lot higher than the 1080 pixels. The aspect ratio calculates the smallest common denominator between the two resolutions. So don't worry if you don't understand what that means, but basically you want to make this 1:1 because we're making a square video, so there's the same amount of pixels in the horizontal as there are the vertical. And the frames per second, if you've got a camera that you're using regularly and you know the FPS that you use on that camera, then I would set this to the same frames per second. For me, I use my phone and it's 30 frames per second, so I'm going to keep 30 frames per second as the default here. The scan mode and color spacing, you don't need to worry about too much. You can leave these as the default settings. I have mine on progressive and 709. It just means that you've got a little bit of more color depth, but they really don't make a huge amount of difference. Click on OK when you're done, and that will set the video mode to the new settings we've just applied. Click on to start, and now drag in some footage into your playlist. Now, as you can see, this has gone back to a 16:9 ratio or a 1080p resolution. This is not what we want here. So come up to settings, click on video mode, and go back to your custom, which in the example I just showed you is square video. This now resizes your video to fit, so nothing is being missed off. So by that I mean if the video was in vertical format, it would squish it with a vertical format with black sides rather than as you see it here with the black top and bottom. By default, it's not going to chop off any of the video content.
Now, just before we continue, if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe and this channel helps YouTubers edit their videos and use free software. If you're creating YouTube videos regularly and not seeing the growth you'd hope for, you're probably missing one or more elements of the video creator framework. You can download the free PDF in the description below to get started. Now, let's get back to the video.
Now, you can drag your clip into the timeline and you can start using it as you would usually, and this would create a resized video to fit a square viewport. Now, the alternative option that you may want when you're creating a video like this is to have zero black on the top, bottom, or sides. So what do we do here? So click onto your video clip, come up to filters, and then click the plus. We want the size, position, and rotate tool. So type in size and click on the filter. This now allows you to zoom in and reposition your content on the screen. So what you can do is on the size mode here, click distort, and then you get the extra options on the sides here. Now you can expand your video to the top and bottom to create a square, which In this case, doesn't work very well, and it might not work very well for you either, but that may be one of the options that you want to use. Alternatively, select it to fill and then expand the edges. So effectively, it zooms in on your video and then center it as you wish. If you want the exact center, then you can click on the little grid icon here and you'll get a nice square grid. You can also select other styles of grid. And when you select the move tool, you can snap to the center so you know that's in the very center of the video. To hide the grid, just click on the grid icon again and it will turn it off. So effectively what you've done here is you've cropped the sides by zooming in on the video. If for any reason you didn't want the exact center, then you can bring it over and manually adjust it. If you've got a video like this, and if I play through very quickly, you may find that to start off with, the video is in the right place, but then by the end of the video, it's actually kind of off center and you didn't want that. Maybe you wanted the video to follow the subject on the screen. Well, if you want to do something like that, then you need to enable keyframes, which is done by clicking this button just here. Go back to the start of your video and set a keyframe. Now go to the end of your video, select the keyframe option again and drag your video so your subject is back into the center. Now when you play through, the subject should stay fairly central and it will look like the subject is moving with the square video. Effectively what we're doing here is panning across the full video, although we can only see a small square in our viewport. Final thing we need to do when we're creating a new video format is check that our export settings are also correct. So before exporting, I usually save just in case anything happens, but then click onto the export options, click onto advance, and then take a look at your video tab. And the resolution is 1080 by 1080, which is correct for me, but the aspect ratio, well, actually this would work, but you want that to be 1 by 1. So it doesn't matter what settings you have on your resolution. If your aspect ratio is 1 by 1, then it will always export in the correct way. Also check your frame rate just to make sure that that is set correctly. But all of these options down here, you can leave as default. Now when you export, it will export as a square.
Please consider liking and subscribing. And before you go, click or tap on the video on your screen right now, and it will continue to help you with Shotcut. I'll see you in the next video.